Can you explain the testing process for the COVID-19 variants?
Well, it's pretty exciting in Ontario now. As of February 3rd, they've started a new process to inform us at a local level whether any of our tests are positive for variants of concern. So just to review, all of our swabs are checked for COVID-19 using a PCR method, so checking for the gene of the virus. We get those results back typically within 24 hours of you going to the assessment center and the sample being submitted. So fabulous turnaround time, and thank you to our lab and our assessment center. Next, if it's a positive sample, it will be sent to Public Health Ontario lab, where they will look for a mutation called the N501Y mutation, which is on the spike protein of the COVID-19 virus. This mutation is found in all of these variants of concern, the B117, which was originally found in UK, the B1.351, which was found in South Africa, and the P.1, which is originally found in Brazil. So this is a very good rapid screening test, just looking by PCR for that one mutation, which is consistent across these three. If that mutation is found, they will then do whole genome sequencing to identify if those variants of concern are even changing further while they're in Canada. And that information gets shared internationally with the World Health Organization. So that's very impressive that that's going to be in play for February. It may get continued to get a better understanding of whether these strains will be taking over on transmission. As well, if you haven't had this mutation detected, they will still sequence around 5% of the other samples to look for a new mutation that's occurred spontaneously within Ontario or Canada. And so 5% of the samples will also be detected through sequencing for any further mutations. So for me at a local level, this gives us comfort that we're monitoring for new change within Ontario and Canada. This gives me comfort that we're looking for the international variants of concern that have been detected elsewhere. And to have this all operational very quickly in Ontario, I think is nothing short of brilliant, and definitely gives us greater situational awareness. If we have any positives detected that have had this N501Y, we will inform our public and we'll be very aggressive in trying to limit the spread of these variants if they're detected in KFL&A.